Hello, everyone. My name is Angela, and I am a sophomore at Harvard University and a 2022 cohort of the World Bank Group's Max Dambizo Edkins Connect for Climate and GYCN Ambassador. I'm joined here today with
Stéphane Hallegatte.
Perfect. A senior climate change advisor at the World Bank during our spring meetings here. So what does your agenda look like for today and for the rest of the week?
So our goal here is really to take our development work, and it's focused on poverty reduction and helping countries achieve their own development objective, and to make sure these development priorities take into account all of the global objectives that we have, including, of course, climate change, but also biodiversity, more resilience to protect people. So the idea is really to align those different goals to have consistent and efficient development pathways for our countries.
That's amazing. So I also know you did a lot of work with the IPCC report. So how does that sort of combine with the work that you do with the World Bank, whether that be through the country reports and other development initiatives?
So I think there is a great tendency to bring together what is science, and the IPCC being a pure example of a body that focuses on research and science, and policymaking. Bringing better information to policymakers is critical. IPCC is one tool that we have to do that. And the World Bank is another, in the sense that we are engaging with policymakers all the time, and we help them get the latest science, the latest economics, the latest data and knowledge, so that they can make the best possible decision. So there is really a continuum between being an academic in a university doing research, being a policymaker or decision maker. We're trying to have like a continuum and to make sure those different people communicate and exchange knowledge.
That makes a lot of sense. I think it'd be really difficult to do climate policy without understanding the science behind it. And I know your background was first in more of the academic setting before you came to the advising role. So how do you think that transition has been for you professionally?
Well, it has been a very step-by-step process, starting from maybe the more like academic work and publishing papers and looking at the problem like in an office, and then starting through the IPCC to think about how to make that information useful, which means different types of research, different types of communication, and also trying to do the research not in the abstract about what's interesting, but the research about what are the questions, what do people need to know, and to start there to define research projects. And so you start to do that, and to do that you need to start to engage with policymaking, and the World Bank being a great place for that, because it's one of the places where policymakers are meeting with the experts. And so very slowly I started to get into that world and to be engaged first on little projects, and then moving full-time with the World Bank to work on this better connection between evidence, knowledge, and policymaking.
That's amazing. And so as someone who's been in like more of the youth climate activist space, how do you see the role of young people in connecting, whether that be in academia or policymaking or somewhere else entirely?
I mean, first we need people to do that work of first looking at the issues, looking at the data, looking at the evidence, learning. So working on the issues themselves, but then taking this knowledge and to do something with it.
Yeah.
And to move to decision making, but that can be many different things. That can be being a policymaker. That can be being in civil society, in NGOs and associations, and trying to promote, even like in a village or a city, trying to push decision making. It can be in science and it can be in places like here. But the really important thing is to try to think about how we make better decisions for people. So really connecting the science with what people want and what people care about. This is the difficult thing, because you need to connect different things with sometimes a lot of contradictions, a lot of trade-offs and conflicts, to find solutions that can work for everyone. But I want to say, what is really important at this point is we have major challenges in front of us. We're still not doing the job on poverty reduction. We're late on that. We have to accelerate and do more. We have climate, we have biodiversity. What's really important is to have like also new blood, new people coming with new ideas, but also a belief that we will be able to make it. And maybe I have a question for you, which is when I ask young people about whether in 2050 we will manage to achieve these net zero emissions that we need to stabilize climate change, do you think we'll be able to make it? Do you think we'll get there?
I think it's our only option. And I think that's what drives a lot of the movement building and consensus and coalition work that is being done by grassroots and young people on the ground.
Because sometimes I feel yes, it's difficult, and sometimes it looks so difficult that doubts about being able to do it is the main obstacle we face. If we don't believe we can do it, it will be very difficult to do it, right? So we really need people to remind exactly what you said, right? That this is the goal, we have to do it because that's the only way to achieve our development goals and offer a good life to all of these people on this planet. So we can't just sit and think, oh, it's really too difficult, right? Mm-hmm. We just have to get on and work on it and make it happen.
Just like you.
Well, trying, part of like thousands of people pushing. And I guess that's a big difference looking back maybe 10 years in the future when you had a community of people trying to push on those issues. Now it's much more like something that everybody knows about. Right. I mean, you talk to any high school students and they know everything about climate and biodiversity and what needs to happen for the environment. So I think we can expect a lot of action and change just because we're moving from this little group of people pushing to something which is really shared across society.
Absolutely. Well, you heard it here first, folks. Thank you so much, Stéphane, for being part of the conversation today, as well as the World Bank for having us during these spring meetings. So stay tuned for more updates during this incredibly exciting week. That's all for now. Thank you.
Thank you, Angela.